Any C program can be divided into five basic sections: header, main, variable declaration, body, return. At start of our program, we must include header files. Only the functions defined in the included header files can be used in the program. Since in our program we need to print something, we'll use the file which defines core input and output functions. We do so using #include with the file name between angled brackets. #include is a preprocessor directory. It will include the file which is given within the angled brackets into the current source file. .h extension means it is a header file. If we don't include the header, then our program won't know the definition of printf and would throw an error. Operating system initiates the program execution by invoking the main function. So in C, the execution typically begins with the first line of main. A function is written in C as return type followed by function name followed by input or set of inputs in braces, which here would be int main void in braces. The int stands for integer because operating system expects an integer value from the main function. That integer value represents the status of the program. If there is any error in the program while execution, the main function will return some non-zero value to the operating system. If the program executes successfully without any error, it will return zero. This void is not necessary, but to write it is considered technically better as it clearly specifies that main can only be called without any parameter. C is a block-structured programming language where statements are grouped together to achieve specific tasks using curly braces. Printf is a function defined in stdio.h header file. It will print everything to the screen which is given inside the double quotes, which in this case is "Hello World." Every statement in C should end with semicolon. When we run the program, the output is "Hello World."